Good morning, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, who gave St. Anthony of Padua to your people as an outstanding preacher and an intercessor in their need, grant that with his assistance, as we follow the teachings of the Christian life, we may know your help in every trial. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the lowly, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord and a day of vindication by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion a diadem instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness in place of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a listless spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The favors of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, my kindness is established forever. In heaven you have confirmed your faithfulness.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David my servant. Forever will I confirm your posterity and establish your throne for all generations.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I have found David my servant. With my holy oil I have anointed him, that my hand may be always with him, and that my arm may make him strong.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
My faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him, and through my name shall his horn be exalted. He shall say of me, you are my Father, my God, the Rock, my Savior.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Every town and place he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Go on your way. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals, and greet no one along the way. Into whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this household.' If a peaceful person lives there, your peace will rest on him. But if not, it will return to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you. For the laborer deserves his payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick in it and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand for you.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We said it often how exciting it must have been for those first disciples and apostles of Jesus to carry out the work of God. It was an awesome task, wasn't it? You could just imagine yourself and myself in their shoes, in their sandals. Well, to go and bring this good news to other people, how powerful and efficacious is God's word. But they had to first believe. And not only believe, they had to be convinced. You and I, each day, enter into our belief and ask God to increase our faith. That belief and that faith gives us conviction that what we say, what we do, and how we believe it is a very powerful gift and grace from God. So let them, so too like us, you and I need to digest this word, this living word, the person of Jesus within us, so that this word may also take flesh in our flesh. Remember, the flesh is the hinge to salvation, isn't it? And to allow God's flesh to be part of us, yes, in Holy Communion, absolutely. But besides the reception of Holy Communion, how does that flesh really cultivate in my actions as another Christ? You know, all baptized people are another Christ, aren't they? Your eyes, your hands, your feet, your words are to bring Christ to other people. We've been baptized into his person. The priests, deacons, and bishops, in another sense, stand in the very person of Christ as servant, as victim, and as guidance and governor, sanctifier and teacher. It's a wonderful gift, but it's a gift that we first have to ultimately realize every day that it is a grace. It's a grace for every single person, never to be taken for granted. So all the baptized must go about their daily business, but in such a way
that whatever they do, it is cultivated by the very living Word of God, living and breathing in them. So all their decisions and deliberations are based upon what the Christian community believes. Today, in a delayed, postponed date, today the Archbishop ordains deacons for the church in Philadelphia, for the archdiocese. And as you know, there are two modalities of the diaconate: the permanent deacon, a deacon who is a permanent one in the life of the church until the day that he dies, and even into eternity, because the sacramental character of the diaconate is lasting for all eternity. It doesn't end at death. And the other modality of the diaconate is the transitional deacons. You know who they are. They're the seminarians who will be ordained a deacon for about 1 year, and then the following year, God pleasing, will be ordained. They will be transitioning to the priesthood. But no matter what, deacon, priest, and bishop, we all remain deacons. We all remain servants of the Lord. You don't throw away the diaconate when they become a priest, right? The seminarians who will be ordained a deacon today with those men who are going to be permanent deacons, they all remain the same character all the way into eternity. But we remember them today as, of course, servants of the Lord. And their primary ministry, they are the ministers of the Word. That's why you proclaim the gospel. You're the minister of the Word, and you assist at the altar. You assist the priest and the bishop at the altar. And also a minister of charity. In a unique way, you have one foot into the ordained world and another foot into the world itself. One foot in the altar area, the divine, and another foot into the world. Having a job, having a family, living in a neighborhood with other baptized people. It's a wonderful gift, the diaconate. And today the church will ordain men to the diaconate in those two modalities. Next Saturday, God pleasing, will be the ordination of priests for the Archdiocese of Philadelphia. So we remember both deacons and priests today, especially when the gospel today said Jesus appointed 72 other disciples whom he sent up ahead of him in pairs to every town and village that he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest." Which is true. That's why every day we pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life. Because we're not going to take for granted, right? It's all a gift from God, a grace from God. So we just can't sit on our laurels and say, "Oh, we're always going to have priests and religious." Not necessarily. We need to pray for those vocations as well, and ask God to increase his church with more deacons and with more religious, with priesthood. And how beautiful that is, that the complementary of the vocations of the church is seen in bright array. You know, all the vocations, the single life, the married life, the diaconate, the priesthood, the religious life, all making a beautiful mosaic of a vocational way of life in order to bring the Lord present among all of us. And the purpose of every vocation is that it sanctifies the individual, right? And the
The second purpose is it gives glory to God. May you and I continue to pray for an increase in vocations. I would be very remiss if I did not mention today is also the memorial of St. Anthony of Padua, that great saint that we always go to if we lose something, right? St. Anthony, please come around. Something is lost that must be found. And don't you know, we always find it. Absolutely. How often do I and you pray that prayer? You know, there's a little joke that as soon as we keep on praying that prayer, poor St. Anthony's like, you lost it again? But he's always there to help us, right? He's always there to find things. But that's not his claim to fame, although that's what the world sees. Poor Anthony says, I did more than just find things for people. Do you know about my life? St. Anthony was an Augustinian. I don't know if you knew that. He was an Augustinian, not a Franciscan. I know you've seen him in the brown habit. Well, shortly after his ordination, he switched communities. He left the Augustinians, and he went to the Franciscans. So he left the Augustinians, and he went to the Franciscans. And he left the Augustinians to become a Franciscan because he saw their work and the work of their they were converting people. He was so impressed with the Franciscan friars that he wanted to enter into their community as a friar minor. And he did. And he was an outstanding preacher. Many people would come and listen to him. You know, I say this often, he had brains to sell, right? Not only did he have brains to sell, but he never flaunted it. You know how sometimes people can flaunt it? You know, you have to say to them, listen, get over yourself. You know, you're not all that. But some people, because they have all of that, they flaunt it. Not Anthony of Padua. He's a very humble friar minor and a humble preacher. And many people have gone to his intercession, asking him for his intercession. And many things, as a conversion of life, as a help in marriage, as a help in their job, help me to find a job, you know, help me to find this, help my daughter or son find their way back to God. So it might not be all finding material things, right? I lost my car keys, I lost my cell phone. St. Anthony, please help me. It's also not only things, but people. Finding their way back to God. How beautiful would St. Anthony love to hear those prayers attributed to him to find people and their way back. So let's continue to pray to St. Anthony for his intercession so that he can pray with us to God and we can grow more in holiness in our ability to go out like the 72 went, to preach the gospel by word and example. But we have to first do it to ourselves and to our own family. And then we can go out. Because it's after we are convinced of what God is doing in us that He will do even more powerful things in our lives. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For those discerning priesthood or religious life, may the Holy Spirit strengthen them and give them wisdom in their decision-making. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For state and federal legislatures, may God inspire them in enacting policy. those suffering from despair. May God's peace comfort them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of this faith community, may the Holy Spirit fill us with a zeal for evangelization. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the 13 men who were being ordained deacons this morning by the Archbishop down at the cathedral, that God will bless them in their ministry and bless their families as well. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may they enjoy eternal life in paradise. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Amy D'Amico Senna, Steve and Anita Sava, Jones Eba, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the living and deceased members of the Casaza family, for who this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God
forever. Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Like the new Paul. so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O my God, my only hope, I have placed all my trust in you, and I know I shall not be disappointed.
harvest the solemnity of the body and blood of the Lord, Corpus Christi. It's a wonderful solemnity in the church, honoring the Most Blessed Sacrament and our belief in the Most Blessed Sacrament. Tomorrow at the Mass, of course, we will pray that Mass of the body and blood of the Lord in a very particular way. And tomorrow is one of those days in which we have a sequence. Remember those sequences that we have in the church? We have it after the second reading, the sequence right before the Alleluia and the Gospel Proclamation. Also, I told you in my afternoon reflection that I'll be having a Corpus Christi procession this year in a different way. We're going to do it through vehicles. So there's a generous Christian who has lent me his truck, and we have set up an altar on the back bay of it, and we'll put the monstrance upon it, and then we'll have our first benediction here in parking lot A, which is the parking lot closest to the annex. And then we'll go around to various streets and pass by and just offer, of course, the graces of the sacrament as we gaze upon the host. We'll stop by the Padua Street. Willowbrook, is it? Is it Avenue? Willowbrook Avenue. And would you mind doing the second benediction for us? And we'll go do the gospel, and that would be very nice. And then we'll end up here for the third. So if anybody wants to come, it'll probably be about 4 o'clock by the time you get back. We're going to start at 2 at the parking lot. Go around different streets, 30 yours, then third, we'll come back here. And should be about 4. Don't hold me back to gospel, you know, because I have no idea about timing and how long it takes, but it should be about that time. So it should be a lovely feast. So we'll do it that way for this year, because we're in this kind of a situation. I think it would be nice as well, because you go around the different places. It was our Kathy Wisniewski, really, who brought that suggestion to me. Kathy is a former CRE coordinator of religious education, but presently the bookkeeper and purchaser. She said, I have something to ask you. How about this year, since we can't do the Corpus Christi procession, why don't we do it by vehicle and go out? And I said, perfect. I said, you go map it out. So her and Peggy went to map out the streets, and they brought it back. It looks very good. You checked with the township, all that went well. And now we'll take care of it tomorrow. So tomorrow about 2 o'clock we'll start, and we'll just go out. So there's a car before me and a car going to be here for me. So that would be very nice. And Susan, as you know, our IT lady in the second pew here, she also designed magnetic decals for the truck. Has the parish crest on it. It looks very, very nice. Susan, she always does a superb job. So thank you, Susan, for that. And thank you for doing this for us. We appreciate everybody who helps us in any particular way. And Peggy, flowers look beautiful for Corpus Christi. I noticed that. I said, oh my gosh, I came out to pass. I thought they were changed. So what's it been, your archangel or anything? Or Bofan?
Yeah, Bofan.
So it's beautiful, the yellow and the white. Of course, they're university colors. So thank you, Peggy, for making that all pretty for tomorrow's Sunday. And finally, if you want to purchase a Father's Day card or a Memorial Day card, living or deceased from your dad, grandpa, uncle, Peggy will be more than happy to help you after Mass. Let's pray, everybody. Through Christ the teacher, O Lord, instruct those you feed with Christ the living bread, that on the feast day of Blessed Anthony of Padua, they may learn your truth and express it in works of charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Have a nice day, everybody.
You too, Father.
Saint Michael,
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou,